you think that you're doing good security by using strong passwords, 2FA. With this cookie stealing, you can bypass 2FA, right?
Absolutely. We are ZTW user, we refresh, and we are ZTW admin. Absolutely. It's just like with software where it can say it does one thing.
Yeah.
What it really does, you don't know.
Hey everyone, David Bumble coming to you from ZTW25, back with Kieran. Kieran, great to see you again.
I see you again.
So, you've got a cool demo. Cookie stealing, is that what it's about?
Yes.
You're going to show us multiple demonstrations of how cookies can be stolen, and then I could get access to someone else's account, or a hacker could get access to your account, is that right?
Absolutely. You can bypass passwords, multi-factor authentication, and there's multiple ways to do it.
Brilliant. Okay, let's get started.
So the first way we're going to do is just through inspect element.
Yep.
This is how we can first see the cookie, and the way that you can do that is right-click and inspect. Then you move over to application.
Yep.
And then under cookies, you want to find the website that you're trying to steal from.
Yep.
For this example, we are going to use GitHub.
Yeah, so a reputable website.
Absolutely. And the name here is the name of the cookie.
Yep.
Each website will have its own different name for what you're trying to look for.
Yep.
So it may take a little bit of testing. With GitHub, you need this saved user sessions and user session. So all we do here is right click, edit value, copy that.
So are you currently logged in as an admin, is that all right? I see you like a user admin. Okay,
yeah.
So the current session is ZTW admin, and that's the cookie that you're going to steal, right?
Yeah, so the victim for this is ZTW admin.
Yep.
And then over here, we have the attacker that I have logged in as ZTW user.
Okay.
So we are going to copy this value here.
Yep.
Go to application, go to that user, saved user sessions.
Yep.
Edit value, paste that in. Do the same with the user session. And with that, we're ZTW user. Refresh. And we're in a ZTW admin.
Wow. So, just that I understand this, because I'm always a bit slow. With this cookie stealing, you can bypass 2FA, right?
Absolutely.
So if I am logged into a website, YouTube or whatever, Gmail, etc., and you did this, no matter if I'm using complex passwords, no matter if I'm using like a 2FA device, YubiKey or something, you could still get in as me.
Absolutely. It's not every website, it is website specific, but in this case, yes.
Very cool. That explains the concept, because I know people are going to say this. It's unlikely that a hacker is going to get physical access to your computer to be able to do exactly what you've done, right?
Mm-hmm.
So in your second demo, you're showing like an example with an extension or piece of software that's installed, correct?
Yeah, so the second example is with a Chrome extension.
Yeah.
And what we are able to do with it is export the cookies as a JSON file. And with that, you can send it over and then the attacker can then view that. We do have a couple other hacking labs that we showed here, how you can quickly data exfiltrate. All you need is about 1 second of physical access, and you have that data.
So you could use like a rubber ducky or some kind of malware software to run on the victim's computer, and then that would just copy the cookies to some storage somewhere online, right?
Yeah, like you said, with that rubber ducky, we also have, actually, the last example will be malware.
Okay, great.
Yeah, so with that Chrome extension, what I like to use is, it's called Storage Ace.
Yep.
So we are going to just click export, and it downloads all of my cookies right there.
So this is the mistake the victim made here, is they installed some dodgy Chrome extension, right?
Yeah.
You could have an extension like Honey, it's a famous example recently, that supposedly is saving you money, but in the background is doing all kinds of interesting things, let us say. Good reason not to install all kinds of extensions on your browser, right?
Absolutely. It's just like with software where it can say it does one thing.
Yeah.
What it really does, you don't know. So even though, sure, in this case, we are physically exporting that file, you don't really know what a browser does. So just be careful installing random applications, random browser extensions.
Yeah.
They can do a lot more than you think.
Yeah.
So here we're just logging in as the attacker.
Yeah.
We're ZTW user.
Yeah.
And here we are ZTW admin. So as the user, again, I can inspect element, go over to that application, and now we're just going to view that export. Now we just need to find that cookie that we are looking for. And here we have the saved user sessions and the user sessions. So we just copy this value over. And then copy the user session. With that, we are ZTW user, we refresh, and we are ZTW admin.
It's crazy how easy it is, right?
Absolutely.
I mean, you think that you're doing good security by using strong passwords, 2FA, simple as that, bypass all of that.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
And for this third example, we are going to use the cookie file.
Yep.
In our original testing, actually, Chromium browsers worked.
Yeah.
That was several months ago. But since then, they have started to encrypt it, so it's a little bit harder.
Yep.
So for this, we are going to use Firefox.
I'm glad you're showing different browsers, though, because it shows you the weaknesses in all browsers, all software, right?
Yeah, it's not just Chrome that's weak. It's not like just Firefox is weak. Everything has its issues. There's, if one way doesn't work, the hacker finds another way.
Yeah.
So here we are, ZTW admin as the victim.
Yep.
And for this, we are going to go to our folder for Firefox.
Yep.
We go to AppData percent AppData percent Mozilla Firefox profiles. You may have to look around, there might be more of these, but just find the right one, and you're looking for cookies. You go to browse data, and you have all those cookies again.
Brilliant. And then it's a simple thing of just copying those, right?
Absolutely. Just copy it over, log in. Everyone knows how to do this.
So you just log in as your normal user, like in this case, ZTW user, and then copy the cookies, refresh, and you're in as another user.
Absolutely.
It's ridiculous.
And there's been a ton of websites. You can test it yourself. It's not just dodgy websites. Here is github.com, very reputable.
Yeah, just like that.
Yeah. And we are ZTW admin. And with this malware, it actually does a lot more than just stealing your cookies. So this one I actually found online, and with it, we can steal your passwords as well. So, and it's all of the major browsers. If you think you're more secure because you're on macOS, you're not.
Sorry, I don't want you to freak out.
I'm freaking out!
It works on macOS, it works on Linux, it works on Windows.
Oh, even Linux, because people who run Linux say we better. We more secure.
No. With that, I do have it downloaded.
So this is on your GitHub, right? You just went to your own, to the ZTW GitHub, so people can find what you're doing here, right?
Absolutely. In here, I have all of the instructions on what I've been doing.
Great.
I have Ducky scripts. I have the instructions, so you can do it yourself as well.
But as always, disclaimer, this is for demo purposes only. Only do this for testing on your own systems or systems you have permission to test on. Don't get into trouble, right?
Absolutely. That is the most important. And that's why at ZTW, we have the laptops, we provide the hardware, we provide the labs so that you can do it, get that hands-on testing for yourself in a safe environment.
Nice.
And with this malware, Windows Defender does pick it up. But what you can do is with the Rubber Ducky, we ran a script, and it is available on the GitHub. We have a script to exclude your entire documents folder from being scanned by Microsoft Defender. So we can run it with no problem.
Nice.
So I have it in my documents over here. It's in ZTW documents for me. And it's called Hack Your Browser. All you have to do is double click it. And any browsers that you have installed that it can hack, it gives you everything. So if we look here in the cookie file for Firefox, we can open it up in Excel. And again, we get all of the cookies that we want.
Blah.
So again, we're going to log in as the attacker to steal it. We go back to application and we just copy that value, paste it, and we'll be in. So I'm going to refresh my browser.
An icon changed.
And there we go. back into ZDWAdmin. Very simple. And also, we'll view that file again over here in the results. It will also give you any passwords that you have saved. So I created a username, password, and then sometimes it'll give you the login URL, sometimes it won't. However, as much as we tell everyone, do not reuse your passwords. People reuse their passwords.
Of course they do.
So if we can steal your login details, we can definitely test some different accounts and see what works.
So Kieran, just remind me, so the GitHub, we'll put the link below so people can go and get the stuff that you've done. So I see you've got like Ducky scripts, like you said. So that's for the Ducky demos that you've done. And in a previous video, you demonstrated the Ducky scripts. So if people want to watch that video, it's linked below. They're the scripts for that. And for this specific video, it's the advanced cookie theft folder, right?
Absolutely, yes.
Okay, so there are all of them that you've just demonstrated, right? So like malware. So if you click on the malware one, because that's probably the one people are most interested in. So that, if you scroll down, that just explains a bit about it, and then you can just download the software from here. Is that right?
Yeah, the software you can find online. If you just Google hack your browser, it will hack your browser GitHub. It will show up. I can, as you can see, it's hackbrowserdata.exe. If you just search for this, it will show up online. Because I didn't make it, someone else had made it, so I am just using that tool. But in the early ones, there are further instructions on just how to go through each thing. If everything, what buttons to press, where to look, and on the first folder in the advanced cookie theft, it tells you which to go through in each step, kind of as they get more advanced.
That's great. So, Christian, if people want to connect to you, can they connect to you on LinkedIn or somewhere? Where's a good way for people to like ask questions or make contact with you?
Yeah, on LinkedIn, Kieran Human. Shoot me a connection request and send me a message.
Brilliant. Kieran, great to see you again, man.
Nice to see you.